Let me ask, which one do you think it is? So when you look at the kumo, the direction of the kumo here, right here, is this moving up or down or range? Which one do you think it is? It's not a trick question. All right, I see up, up, up. Sure, it's moving up, right? It's moving up like this way. You guys are right. That's perfect. Already make money with that. The kumo is moving up, and that means the market is on a trend. If you look back, like let's say, right, in the past market to like this way, right? Up to here. Oh, by the way, this is a EURJP daily chart. And if you look at the angle of the kumo in the past, is it moving up or down or horizontal? Which one do you think? Again, this is not a trick question. So it's a simple question. Down, 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 right? Yeah, it's moving down, exactly. Again, you can make profit with that, right? That's simple. That's it. One of the things that you have to remember is that kumo is actually 26 candles moving ahead. That means when you look at the kumo is moving up, actually this is not when you are looking at the market. We're exactly looking at the market when kumo is moving up is actually 26 candles before. Let me do this. Place a vertical line here and I will take 26 candles from this day to 26 candles backwards. It's going to be on this day, right? From this day to this day, there are 26 candlesticks. That means 26 trading days. So actually, when you look at the angle of the kumo is moving up, you are actually not looking at this market, but you're looking at like this. If I shift it, it's going to be this market. And when you're looking at the kumo is moving down, actually, this is the market that you're looking at, the downtrend, because kumo is 26 candles forwarded. So that means if you switch back the 26 candles before, that's exactly when the market is moving. Is it clear? Again, kumo is 26 candles moving forward. So you're looking at actually looking at the kumo is moving up right now, but actually that was happening 26 candles before. So you have to take that into consideration. So you always have to go back 26 candles before and compare the market in the past so that you can fully capture what was going on in the market. So some people only look at the kumo was moving down like this day, right? They think that kumo is moving down and that was until this day, right? The kumo was moving down until this day. But actually it's not because it's 26 candles forwarded. So actually this day, when the kumo was forming, actually that was on this candlestick right here. And that's why if you move the whole chart 26 candles before, it's gonna be like this. When the kumo is moving down, this is exactly when you want to take trades. And when kumo is moving up, this is exactly when you want to take trades. Okay, that's the first rule. Always look at the angle of the kumo first. Simple, right? It's simple. You can actually visually recognize the angle of the kumo. When the kumo is moving up, that's when you want to take trades. And when the kumo is moving down, that's when you want to take trades. Because that means the market is on a trend. That's the most simple way to recognize market, whether you want to take trades or not, is by looking at the angle of the kumo. The kumo is moving up this way. So this is when you want to take trades. On this market, it's a bullish momentum. So you look for where to buy in this momentum. You look for where to buy. You don't look for where to sell in this case. You only look for where to buy. And when the kumo is moving down, we only look for where to sell. We never look for where to buy. We only look for where to sell in this momentum when the kumo is moving down because it's going to be the most time efficient in the market. You can let the time work for you in that case. This is a gold daily chart. When you look at the kumo right now, probably from this candlestick, just roughly here. If you look at the kumo right now in this gold daily chart, is this moving up or down or horizontal? Again, this is not a trick question. Just answer to my question with your simple eyes. Just focus on the kumo here, right? Don't look at the candlesticks. Don't look at any other things. Just focus on the kumo. It's range, right? You guys are right. When it's moving horizontal, what would you do? When it's moving horizontal, would you buy or would you sell? What would you do? When the kumo is moving horizontal, yeah, let me just explain here. Exactly, it's no trade. So unless you see that kumo is moving up next time, you won't buy in this momentum because the market is horizontal. Market is consolidating right now. So in this momentum, you never take trades by looking at the kumo. But before, previously, when you look at the market and when you look at the Kumo only here, probably up to this day, right here like this, was the Kumo moving up or down or horizontal? In the past here, which one is it? Up, 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 up. Yeah, exactly. It was moving up, right? Clearly. In this momentum, you only look for the place to buy. It doesn't mean that you can buy any place, but you only have a mind that you will buy somewhere, right? You will find a trading edge on the market to buy in this momentum. When the Kumo is moving horizontal, that means you never take trades, no matter what. In this short time period, looks like the market is moving up. In this short time period right here, maybe you might think, oh, the market is moving up, so you buy. Or in this short period here, you might think the market is going down, so okay, it's sell. Maybe you might think like that. But if you keep doing that, you'll be fooled around by this small momentum in the market, and you will get lost cut so many times, and you get lost eventually. So to avoid that, you have to be able to identify when to take trades and when not to take trades. And that's something that you can tell by Kumo here. When the Kumo is moving horizontal, it's no trades, no matter what, it's no trades. And when the Kumo is moving up, it's a buy, no matter what. When the Kumo is moving down, no matter what, it's a sell. And again, this is drawn 26 candles ahead, so you have to calculate, you have to actually measure 26 candles bars before, which is going to be on this candlestick right here. I will put the horizontal here. So from this day, actually from here when the Kumo became horizontal, actually it was on this market right here. So on this candlestick exactly, this is when the Kumo moved, started to be horizontal. On this day, the Kumo just started to be horizontal. On this day, from this day, you never take trades. But before that, you take trades. As long as the Kumo is moving up. The Kumo started to move up from here, right? From this day. And if you go 26 candles before, it was actually on this day, right here. You see 26 bars? That means it's a 26 candles from this candle, from this day here, right? And this is exactly when the Kumo started to move up. So if you take 26 candles backwards, it's going to be on this candlestick right here. I would look for a buy chance from this candlestick right here. I will look for where to buy only from this candlestick up to this candlestick. I will never think of selling it whatsoever, and I will never think no trades whatsoever. I will only think where to buy in this momentum, right? I will only think where to buy, where to buy, where to buy, where to buy. Every day, I will think where to buy when, as long as the Kumo keeps moving up. Where is the trading edge to buy on this market, right? But right now, the Kumo is moving horizontal, so I won't look at the chart even. Probably in the lower time frames, I will take a look at it and take trades. But in this daily chart, I wouldn't decide where to take trades because the Kumo is moving horizontal, and that means the market is in the range.